PowerPoint recently got some new features and some improvements on existing features. For example, it got improvements to the designer, easier management of inserted objects, and new features so you can present with confidence and make your slides more engaging. There are also some really cool productivity features that you might have missed, so let's start with that. Number one, Word to PowerPoint. Now this feature has been there for a while, but it's one of those features that you might have missed because it's only available on the web. So you worked hard and you created this Word document. Now your boss comes over and tells you that you should create slides based on this and present this in the next meeting. With Office 365, you can easily do that. You just have to open your Word document on the web, so with Word on the web, then go to File, Export, and Export to a PowerPoint presentation. Here you get to decide between different themes. Now every time you run this, so I ran this before and I saw completely different themes to what I'm seeing right now. Just pick the one that you think fits best. I'll actually go with this one and click on Export. Now keep in mind that it currently works only for the English language and it currently doesn't bring over any tables or images that you have in Word. But you do get nice images and a nice way of presenting the text because the designer AI is at work and it tries to figure out what type of image to show for your text. So here I have this nice title slide. I also get the chance of changing my title slide with different ideas from designer. I have the important parts of my text split into separate areas here. I have these nice boxes, a nice color scheme. I can, of course, go ahead, update the text, update the images, the colors as I choose. Now you can continue to work on this on the web or open this on your desktop and continue from there. It just helps you save a ton of time than if you were going to create this from scratch. Number two, automatic slides from agenda. So speaking of speeding up your work with the help of the designer, let's assume that you don't have a starting Word document and that you're creating your presentation from scratch. So I'm going to go to the browser and type in powerpoint.new to create a brand new PowerPoint presentation. Let's add a title for this. You can use Designer and choose a nicer, fancier slide. So I'm going to go with this one. And now let's go ahead and add a new slide. So for the title, we're going to call this Agenda. Now let's type out our agenda. So we have marketing plan, marketing risks, brainstormings, and other topics. Okay, so these are going to be our agenda. Now check this out. Designer kicked in and added this new feature, add next four slides automatically, because it understood that these are going to be separate slides. I'm going to go ahead and click on add slides. It's loading and my slides are automatically added. Number three, autofix. So PowerPoint already has some great features for aligning objects. It now has an even greater feature called autofix. With autofix, it tries to figure out how to best align and fix the objects. So take a look at this. I have these different objects. They're the same shape, just different size and spread out not so nice on the slide. I'm going to select all of them, go to shape, arrange, autofix. This is going to try to figure out how to best fix and fit the objects on the slide, and it's made them the same size and nicely organized. So this works on different shapes as well, or a combination of shapes, icons, and even images. It doesn't, however, work on smart art or grouped or overlapping shapes, and is currently only available on the web. Number four, lock objects. So you have your objects perfectly aligned and you don't want to move or distort them by mistake because it's really easy when you come to start typing that you could start moving stuff around and messing up your nice design. So to lock your objects, you have to open your presentation in PowerPoint in the desktop app. So this is available on desktop. You're going to select the objects that you want to lock, then right mouse click and lock. This makes sure that you can't move these objects anymore. So something I always tend to do is by mistake end up moving my title of the slide. You can lock that as well. Right mouse click and lock. Now you can't move that anymore. You can make changes to the text You can also make changes to the color of your object. You just can't change the size and you can't move them around. You can also still apply animation to these. You can also send them to the back or bring them to the front. By locking them in place, you prevent accidental changes from happening. If at any point in time you want to unlock them, select your objects, right mouse click, and unlock. Now you can move these around and adjust the size as you need. Number 5, presenter coach. So you have your perfect slides and your presentation is visually stunning and perfect, but that's only half the work. You still have to present it and bring your points across. That's the part that terrifies me and a lot of people. Public speaking can be stressful, but it just gets better with practice. So it might be good to rehearse giving the presentation in advance. Now, ideally, you want to rehearse with a non-judgmental audience where you can get objective feedback. But if you feel awkward in front of a person, you might find it easier to rehearse with a machine. That's where Presenter Coach comes to the rescue. It's a feature that's been around for a while, at least in PowerPoint for the web and in the preview channel on the desktop app, but not many people know about it. Recently, it got additional features for the web version where it also examines your body language as well. So here's how it works. You go to Slideshow and select Rehearse with Coach. You get this nice welcome box. Click on Got It. Now, you are going to start rehearsing, so I'm just going to start talking and saying how great this presentation is because we are talking about marketing, and marketing is a great topic to talk about. Notice that the coach is listening, and let's say I'm done now. I'm just going to pause the session, think about what I want to say, and then continue, and then go through the next slides and talk about everything, and then I'm finally done, and I get this wonderful report about my pace, which just seems to be right. That's a good one. I didn't have any fillers in place and I didn't use repetitive language. So the built-in AI listens to you present, and if you have your camera activated, it's going to watch your body language during the presentation. Now, we couldn't see the body language here, but you would get a warning when you're too far or too close to the camera, and when you look away from the camera or cover your face. So if you break eye contact, you are going to get a warning. Why? Because you need to make a connection with your audience. Now, of course, you can go back and repeat the rehearsal until you feel confident to present in front of a real audience. Number 6, record and narrate. So PowerPoint's recording options have been there for some time, except they got some new improvements. We have a new recording button directly on top here. So whenever you're ready to record your presentation, just click that and you go into recording view. So here we have the teleprompter. This is based on your notes that you've added. In this case, I don't have any notes for the title slide, but I have some notes for this one and I can see it in teleprompter view. So you can see my camera was automatically activated. I can turn it off or on and also control the audio here as well. Now, you have some more options. You have the teleprompter view here. You have presenter view that allows you to see the next slide. And then you just have the standard slide view. I'm going to go back to teleprompter view. You can also blur your background if you want and use the different annotations down here. So I have a separate video on this that takes you through it in a lot more detail. But just to show you how easy it is to record, all you have to do is click on this. You're going to see the countdown and then you're live, you're going to record. So here you can read from the text that you have on your teleprompter. You can use the different annotations. Okay, I jumped a slide, but you can use the different annotations here if you want. And if you mess up, it's not a problem. You can always go back and correct whatever you messed up on. So if I stop this here, notice you have the option to retake, but you don't have to retake everything. You can do a retake on a current slide. So if you jump too fast, like I did in my other slide, I can go back to that slide. I think it was this one here. And then I can select retake on current slide and just redo that video alone. Okay, so once you're done, you can go and edit. So here you go back to your slide view. You can go check out each slide. So I'm going to go to this one. And let's say I want to listen to what I said. I can play this here. If I want to trim something, I can go to playback and trim the video. So let's say I want to trim the beginning part. I can trim that part, trim the end if you want, and then click on OK. Under video format, you can change your video shape. So if you prefer to have it in a circle, you can choose a circle, crop, adjust as you need. Once you're done, you can export everything into an MP4 file. So you can export everything as a video presentation. So you're going to go and create a video, click on create video, and then export. This might take some time depending on the length of your presentation. Once you're done, you're going to get an MP4 file that looks like this. Number 7, Cameo. So you've probably delivered many presentations in Teams with your video on and you were somewhere around the corner. But what if you could become part of your presentation? Cameo, the latest feature that's released by Microsoft in PowerPoint, allows you to do that. You can insert your live video feed directly into your presentation. You just have to go to Insert, Cameo. You can adjust your camera style, so I'm going to go with this one. Now, this is just a placeholder. The moment I turn on the camera, it's going to be a live feed, and I'm going to show that to you in a second. But the great thing about this is that this is a shape just like any other shape in PowerPoint. You can put it behind objects. You can copy and paste it. And let's say on this slide, I want it up here. And I also want to change it to a circle when I talk about marketing risks. And to make sure the transition is smooth, I'm going to go to Transitions and activate the Morph transition. Okay, so now let's check this out. I'm going to turn on my camera. Okay, so let's go to presentation mode. It's quite dark here. It's kind of late. Okay, so let's say I'm talking about marketing and that's what's on the slide. And then now let's talk about marketing risks. And we can see that Morph is in play and we get this really nice smooth effect. Okay, so that's Cameo for you, the last new feature that we're covering today. Okay, so that's my list of PowerPoint features you might have missed. Let me know in the comments which ones you knew. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, hit that thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe in case you aren't subscribed yet. And I'm going to see you in the next video.